find the Magic Studio just below the home icon, and you're going to click and open the Magic Studio. Most of these features are for pro users. I have signed in on my free account so that we can have a look at the two exciting changes that Canva has implemented with the Magic Media. With your free account, you get access to text to video as well as text to image. With the text to video, you get 5 credits lifetime, meaning you can ask the software to give videos 5 times, and fortunately that's it if you're using a free account lifetime. And with the text to image, you get 50 credits in the lifetime of your account. So we've seen text to image, but I want to show you something quite exciting when you're using correct prompts. Let's start with text to video. You're going to open text to video. Fairly simple. Canva is going to show you how to do it, but they will guide you as well to say, write prompts to the AI software that's going to help you get whatever you want. They say to us, here's a text to video. It's in beta state, and this is where you write your prompt. So the concept of garbage in, garbage out still stays with video or text, whatever. So whatever you're writing to the software to generate a video, that's what's going to happen. It will generate whatever input you put in. And when you've typed in, like Canva has asked us to, you click on generate video. The video is generated and it's playing. And it's got aliens. So if you want to use this, you're going to click on it once. You're going to add it to your canvas. And then you can size it whichever way you want to size it. And then you can have a look and see and time it. And you know the normal timings that you would use it and tweak on Canva. So let's have a look at the video. Next, let's look at Magic Media when it comes to text to image. I cannot stress enough the fact that you need to be using prompts to get exactly what you want. Write your prompts and include keywords like Pixar style, as well as typography, as illustration. So be descriptive as much as possible to get what you want. For now, I'm happy. I'm not going to choose any style. I'm going to leave Canva to choose a style for me. However, you can pick any kind of style that you want, as well as the type of sizing that you want. So let's make it landscape, and then you click on create an image. And our little girl looks like that. So you can click and edit, and she's just beautiful and gorgeous. And there's different kinds of images that you pick, especially if you use the prompt Pixar style. So be descriptive as much as possible. Look how beautiful she is. You can make her sitting in front of a laptop having glasses, and so be descriptive with the AI in order for you to get the images that you want. Sneak this one in. I didn't want to break your heart on the free account, but Canva has switched up the resizing. It's now called Magic Switch. You just have to click one or two more places in order to get what you want. You can translate to another language, which is now part of the Magic Switch. You can transform this into a document for blog posts, songs, etc. That's quite cool. And then you can do the normal one that we're used to resize to a size that we want. And categories are also on here. We didn't have categories before. I could be wrong. Let me know. What I absolutely love is the fact that you could choose which page you want to resize. So you could click on the drop down and you could select the page that you want to resize and only that page. It works very similar to when we are printing, which is absolutely amazing. Our Magic Studio is Morph. I am loving Morph. It is you applying an element and then you're changing it to, and you're morphing it into something else. So you're going to click on it and then you're open the app and you have Morph. In order for us to experience the Morph, as you see the example that Canva has given us on there, I thought let's put it onto a test, and like they did on Illustrator when you're creating a fur, let's morph a logo into a fur. Let's jump in and do that. With our Magic Morph, you can select the element, like selecting it and adding it to the space, or you could add a shape like a star or text and any other element. So I'm going to stick with the letters that we've added there. That's number one. Number two, you're going to describe the object, colors, location, surroundings, etc., etc. In the describe the look, and you do have examples that Canva has loaded for you at the bottom of the page, and you can morph it to these different kinds of examples. But it's very important to be descriptive when you are including the description of the look on this section. So I want a fluffy, and I click on Magic Morph, and it is included and it's added and it's done. It is not perfect. I click on it once and my furry look looks like that. By far, it's not perfect, but it is something that we can work on and tweak and as we go along to make it our own. That's your Magic Morph. We're going to be using my very good friend Michelle, and her channel's name is called Creative Business Muse. She has a video where she's created a thumbnail that is self-talk, and the thumbnail that was done is somebody looking at themselves face to face. So we're going to recreate this thumbnail for her. Please go watch Michelle's videos. She talks business and coaching for women for business. Such a beautiful information that she shares on there. Please go jump in and watch her content. The actual thumbnail started with somebody looking at the mirror because we found the picture on Canva and the person is talking to themselves. It evolved to somebody looking face to face and they're talking to themselves. Then we thought, let's put it into action and use Canva's Magic Grab and Magic Expand. So we're gonna go to the Magic Studio. Canva promises us that this Magic Studio is all power of AI in one place. So we're going to put it to test now and try it. So we want to use the Magic Expand and Magic Grab. We're going to scroll down and we can pick the Magic Grab and the Magic Expand. We've found an image, we've added on there, and we want to expand the image. What Canva says is you select the photo, you click on edit photo, and you go to Magic Expand. This is a pro feature, as well as Magic Grab is a pro feature. So you're going to click on Magic Expand and you're going to tell Canva where you want to expand this photo to. Select a size with the free form or the whole page or the one by one, and it's up to you. And once you've selected the area that you want the AI to expand to, you click on Magic Expand and you wait for magic to happen. And we have different versions. They've added another person. There's another version where it's just the two of them. It has just expanded the image to the areas that we've selected. I want this option and I'm happy with the results, and I'm just expanded this image and it looks like that. And with Magic Grab, what the AI is doing, you're going to grab any element on the image and you move it to wherever you want it to move it to. So because we are helping Michelle with her channel Creative Business Muse, we don't want her anymore. We want this lady to be talking to herself. So we're going to select the image and we're going to click edit photo, and then we're going to select Magic Grab. It's done. What did it do? It grabbed the two ladies, and now I can manipulate the photo with the Magic Studio. I don't want this lady anymore. I just want this lady to be talking to herself. So I'm going to manipulate the picture, but that's what Magic Grab does. I'm going to fast forward this process because you've seen the features. We're going to edit on the Creative Business Muse and the self-talk. Those are the features we're covering on this video. I don't want the video to be long. So let me know in the comments below if you're enjoying these new features. If you want to go and watch Canva's AI in action with animation, go watch this video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I appreciate your time and respect it. I will see you on the next video.